Welcome to another edition of Inside Medicine. I'm your host, Doug Geinzer, the CEO of Las Vegas Heels. And we're here in the studio today with Jeff Grahling, the interim president for SilverSummit Healthplan. For those of you that are new to Inside Medicine, we broadcast live in the studio on Thursdays at 10 a.m. If you happen to miss this episode or want to catch an old episode, you could see us on our website. You could also go to youtube.com. You could catch us on Roku, Stitcher, Spotify, iTunes, and just about every one of those channels that's available out there. We like to bring in movers and shakers in the healthcare space right here in Las Vegas, Nevada, those that are doing good things to improve the quality of healthcare right here in Southern Nevada. And we're going to learn a little bit about SilverSummit today. New entrance, but not so new. We're about ready to celebrate a two-year anniversary of bringing in a new Medicaid plan to Nevada, which was much, much needed. Jeff, welcome to the studio.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, we want to get to know a little bit about you. We want to get to know a little bit about SilverSummit and what you have to offer. So before we get started, the audience always likes to know about you. Okay. So tell us a little bit about your background and some of what you've been involved with.
So I've been with Centene Corporation for a little over 7 years. So Centene is the parent for SilverSummit Healthplan. And I've spent most of my career in managed care and in healthcare technology. I've been in a couple of different Centene health plans, mm-hmm. with SilverSummit being the most recent.
Yeah, we you know, a lot of people don't know, but Las Vegas Heels was very, very involved in expanding Medicaid in Las Vegas or in the state of Nevada. So at one point we lined up the CEOs of all of our hospitals, basically locked arms and said, Governor, we need your help here. Mm-hmm. Our hospitals are bleeding. We're in a very bad place. The ACA allows for the expansion of Medicaid and we need this to happen. We know, mm-hmm. it's unpopular for a Republican governor, but it's all about Nevada right now. And right. Unfortunately, Governor Sandoval was the first governor. Republican right. governor to sign off on it. So that's it's, right. And that led to us having to put an RFP out to, which you all were a winner of. So mm-hmm. congrats on that, but
thank
it's,
you.
It means a lot to us here in Nevada. You guys have been doing amazing work and, changing the landscape, which we so desperately need.
And we continue to be very focused on leveraging what we would consider to be the best of Centene capabilities right here in Nevada.
What's cool is you could look across the country because you guys are the 800-pound gorilla out there and bring right. best practices, what has worked, what has not worked in other states, bring it right here. So let's dive in a little bit. Tell us a little bit about the SilverSummit plan and what that does and what that means to Nevada, because it's different than what we typically think of with Medicaid.
Right. So SilverSummit, we are coming on our two-year anniversary in July of this year, and we serve Nevadans that are eligible for Medicaid, as well as Nevadans that are purchasing their individual coverage, health coverage, on the state marketplace.
And I think I shared with you, I am a customer yeah. of Ambetter. And,
thank you for your business.
It has been, it's exactly what I was expecting yeah. and what I needed.
Yeah, and we're extremely proud of what we've been able to do with Ambetter. And it is meeting a very important need in the healthcare landscape, but that need was, you know, fairly largely unmet prior to the passage of the Affordable Care Act.
Yeah.
We're extremely proud to be able to serve both of those constituencies here in the state. And we are nationally within the Centene family, we are the largest managed Medicaid organization across the country. We're the largest marketplace managed care company across the country. We're the largest Medicaid entity that provides long-term services and supports home and community-based services to Medicaid managed care members. We are able to leverage all of that knowledge and experience in 30-plus states across the country right here in Nevada.
And that's great because we have a long ways to go, as I'm sure you've yep. experienced.
Yes, you know, and truthfully, every state has its own challenges, and Nevada has its particular issues and priorities. And you know, we take that seriously. We're very proud to be part of, you know, the effort to address improving the quality of care for Nevadans, and particularly for Nevadans that are enrolled in Medicaid. because we think that we do that particularly well. And, you know, we feel like we might even do that better than our competitors. So we want to be able to make sure that we are executing on that here in the market.
And I think it's fair to assume and probably quantify that Medicaid is the largest insurer in the state of Nevada right now, because there's, what, 660,000 lives?
Yes. Yep. Including fee-for-service. That's right.
And so that's a big population.
It's a big population. And, you know, and then if you drill into that a little bit, you know, and again, this is not inconsistent with other states, but it's roughly one of every two births in Nevada are covered by Medicaid.
Wow. So I want to talk a little bit about open enrollment. And I think there's a lot that we can learn about. What does that process look like? How does it occur? Yeah. And how do people change plans?
So open enrollment in Nevada occurs from April through June every year. And it's an opportunity for those individuals who are currently enrolled in Medicaid to choose or reselect who they would like their managed care organization to be. And we are one of three choices in the market today. There are things that we offer that we think are very unique. We have value-added benefits. For example, we reward for healthy behaviors, for preventive care services and such. And we are promoting that during the April to June timeframe to make sure that those folks who have the choice are making the most informed choice and are aware of the advantages of SilverSummit.
So Las Vegas Heels is by far the largest professional association of providers in the state of Nevada. We represent groups that employ about 34,000 healthcare professionals. Mm-hmm. What should the providers know about SilverSummit?
Yeah, so we have, as I said, we're in 30-plus states nationally under the Centene family of managed care plans. And, you know, we take great pride in working very closely with our providers in all markets to where, you know, we are focusing on not just managing utilization or achieving the most efficient outcomes. That's certainly it's very important. It's what the state is expecting us to do. But we want to work very closely with those provider partners to make sure that we are achieving together the highest quality of outcomes for our members.
And so you mentioned before you're one of three Medicaid providers. What makes you different?
Yeah, so this is where on the Medicaid side, you know, we have done this in many markets where you're entering a market, you're looking to establish those close provider relationships, and through that, sharing information that's actionable to move the needle both on the utilization or cost side as well as on the quality side. We think we can do that very well. The way we approach any market that we're in, and certainly Nevada is no different, we are a local plan. Any activity that touches a provider or a member here in Nevada is done by a local staff. And we have a large number of employees here in Las Vegas, and we've got some staff in Reno as well, where we are constantly out in the community engaging with members where they are, and certainly engaging with providers in their various community centers or clinics, offices, hospitals, and so forth, to make sure that we are active participants in the delivery of healthcare.
And it's, you know, you touched on before that Centene's this massive, it's a Fortune 100 company, I believe, but you brand everything locally.
That's
so
right.
We have a local brand and it's all local people that
That's
are
right.
delivering services to the population. So, you know, talk about some of the other things about the benefits of being able to leverage Centene.
Right.
You know, you have so many resources. How does that really help Nevada?
So I think the importance of Centene as sort of the platform, they have great dashboard reporting, analytics, helping us drive into insights on what's going on in our particular market. But the way we are set up to operate and to manage our business, the corporate folks don't make the local decisions. The local leadership and the local plan does. And so we leverage best practices. We leverage lessons learned across 30-plus states. But we are responsible here locally to make sure it works for our Nevadans, for the you know, Southern Nevada market and for the Northern Nevada market, which are different markets. And that autonomy, I think, is very important. It's part of what makes us unique and allows us to make sure we're meeting the specific needs of the members in our community.
And Centene's not just national. You guys are international, aren't
we
you?
We are. Yes, we are. We started, expanded internationally probably about 5 years ago, and are continuing to expand that. But it's all the same model where it's those decisions are not being driven by our corporate office. Those decisions are being driven by management teams that are managing those businesses locally.
And I think Centene has 48,000 employees. Yeah. How many do you have here in Nevada? And talk to us a little bit about your workforce here in the state.
So we've got about 150 employees here in Nevada, mm-hmm. And growing. We continue to add staff, which is a good thing. It's a good thing. It's interesting. When I joined Centene many years ago, we were about 9,000 employees.
Oh my gosh. So you've seen just explosive growth.
And, we often talk about making sure that we're building our bench and building the team. We have a lot of opportunities for growth. We just need to make sure that we've got the people to go along with those opportunities.
So, with that, having that large of a team, the members mm-hmm. benefit the most.
Yes.
Talk to us a little bit about what those member benefits look like and what makes those unique.
Right. So we have a full range of functions here in Nevada. We have call center staff here in Nevada for both members and providers that understand the care delivery landscape in our state. We've got SilverSummitHealthplan.com, which is our website, which also has a lot of online tools, resources, and capabilities. But specifically for our members, we have value-added benefits that we think are unique and encourage them to be well and to stay well. And so, as I mentioned earlier, if a expecting mom is getting her prenatal care visits, she can earn rewards for that. And the rewards are, it's not cash, it's what we call a stored value card, but it's the equivalent of cash, and they can be used to purchase over-the-counter medicine, purchase diapers, formula, things of that nature. But that rewards that member for taking steps to be healthy. Similarly, if a mom or a parent is taking their child to be immunized, if a member is going for an annual wellness visit, those are all things that reward those members. And again, we think that's very important. Now, separately, we also reward our primary care groups, our primary care physicians, who are improving. It's called HEDIS, the Healthcare Effectiveness Data Information Service.
And the HEDIS score.
HEDIS score, right, which are very important and, something that the state looks at to assess an MCO or managed care organization's ability to drive quality measures, quality outcomes. But separate from the rewards that we offer for our members, we also tailor specific benefits for members beyond that. So, for example, we offer free dental care at community health centers for members that are 21 years or older. Those under that age are eligible for other dental care, dental coverage. So we offer that to members of a certain age. We offer diabetics additional value-added benefits, such as an Amazon Prime membership, and things like mobile phones that are available for our members. So these are all, again, value-added benefits that we think are unique for Silver Summit, but where it's tailoring our offering to the unique needs of the communities that we serve.
It's unique. We all talk about how we don't have a healthcare delivery system. We have a sick care mm-hmm. delivery system.
That's right.
And these things seem to be moving more towards preventative care, because if we could keep them out of the hospitals, we all win.
Yeah, Doug, I think you captured it exactly right. And that's part of that broader shift, I'm sure you've been have had numerous discussions on the shift of pay for value and moving away from pay for volume. And that's also something that we're very engaged in and looking to, move in that direction in a responsible way.
Yeah, I just returned. I was in Washington, D.C. last week for the World Healthcare Congress. And mm-hmm. I could tell you this was the talk about how we need to move towards a value-based system and how we need to become a wellness care.
Yes.
How do we get our populations healthier rather than waiting for them to present in the ER, which is the highest cost delivery system out there? And sounds like you guys are well on your way.
Right. And, this is not going to happen overnight. And CMS is certainly working very hard, diligently on moving sort of Medicare program more broadly into that direction. But we all have an important role to play there, because it is about ensuring that over time we're getting to the right setting for care. And, you know, trying to, I mean, inpatient stays, there's a lot of additional risk that goes along with, you know, an individual receiving the care in a hospital. And so to the degree we can prevent that or guide to an alternative setting that's more efficient, but also higher quality, you know, that also is very important.
Of course. I want to hear a little bit more about Ambetter, because that's, as I shared with you, I am an Ambetter client. So I found myself in a sticky wicky situation where I've got Las Vegas Hills that has employees, but I'm not an employee of Las Vegas Hills.
Right.
I'm a contractor to it.
Yes.
And all of a sudden, you know, I get my team on one of the new association health plans and I submitted myself with it and I got rejected. And all of a sudden I found myself without insurance. I went, oh, crap, what do I do? And so I went to the exchange and went, Ambetter, hey, these are great clients and great members of Las Vegas Hills. And I laid out all the benefits of it and it made sense. So I joined and I've been very satisfied. But tell us a little bit more about Ambetter.
Sure. So, and I'll go back a little bit, because I was part of the group that launched Ambetter for Cynthia.
Okay, so you've got like real experience with this. Yeah.
And you know, this was back in 2014, but we launched in nine states back then. And really for us, you know, we are very focused on government sponsored programs. So Medicaid, Medicare. And we looked at the marketplaces, the exchanges that were rolling out under the Affordable Care Act. And those were individuals that we felt had kind of been underserved or had needs that were largely unmet in the previous world, in the previous individual insurance world. Many of our national competitors, including some of our competitors here in Nevada, they are primarily commercial managed care companies. Mm-hmm. And Centene's really not one of those companies. We wanted to move into the marketplace market or segment, if you will, and target individuals like you and individuals that also would be eligible for subsidies on those exchanges. Subsidies to both purchase their insurance, as well as subsidies on some of the cost sharing, copays and deductibles that they may have received as part of their coverage under the marketplace. And so we did that, and we focused specifically on the individual market. So we won't offer, you know, there are some states that have small group exchanges, and, you know, we don't participate in those. And so similarly in Nevada, we are offering Ambetter for individuals. Those are individuals that are purchasing insurance for themselves or their families. And, you know, we entered this market in 2018, January of 18. Just had our most recent open enrollment back in the fall of 18 and for 2019 coverage. You know, we grew, you know, pretty significantly. And so we're very pleased with that. It's about offering products on the insurance marketplace that will meet the needs of that individual consumer. And, you know, offer a compelling value in that, in terms of, you know, it's an affordable product on the marketplace. It's got a comprehensive set of benefits, which some of that is mandated. But there are also, you know, some value-added benefits. We have My Health Pays under Ambetter, which, similar to the rewards that we offer on Medicaid, it encourages that healthy behavior.
Yeah, and for me, it's quite easy. I had the same primary care physician for years. And as I was transitioning, I put a call to him. I said, hey, do you take Ambetter? He said, I sure do.
Yep.
Done. I signed up and I was able to get it done in like 20 minutes online.
Right. And, you know, in any of these products or programs, you've got to make sure that you've got a robust network. And, you know, we have done that on the Medicaid side, and we certainly have done that on the Ambetter side, where we have a broad range of providers that are, that our members have access to, whether they be primary care, the hospitals that folks are typically going to, you know, labs, pharmacies, what have you. You know, it's a pretty broad network.
And I got my telemedicine card in the mail yesterday. I got back from a trip to Boston. I came in and said, I wonder what this is. I opened it up and here's this card, and I'm, you know, knock on wood, I hope I don't get sick. But at the same time, I kind of look forward to using it, because I've never tried that type of telemedicine where, hey, my allergy meds just ran up. Can you call in a prescription for me?
Right. Right. And virtual care or telemedicine, I mean, there are a lot of applications of that today, and folks are busy. And folks like you are very busy. What we don't want you to do is not access care in some form or fashion. an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure.
Absolutely.
So to the degree you can engage with a virtual provider and get some feedback on what your issue may be and, you know, how to treat it, that's pretty important.
So I want to dive in a little bit about community outreach, because Silver Summit's everywhere. Everywhere I turn, I see your folks wearing shirts, your people are out in the community, your brand is everywhere. That's a big thing for Centene and for Silver Summit. Tell us a little bit more about your community outreach efforts.
So, you know, high level, we want to walk the walk. We want to be genuine in terms of our mission and purpose. And, we want to improve the lives of in the communities that we serve, one member at a time. Get that health improvement train rolling, right? And so we certainly view being in the community, sponsoring activities, sponsoring a lot of events at schools, which we have done with the Vegas Golden Knights here locally, to really demonstrate to the communities that we are more than just, you know, being your typical managed care company. Now, it also helps. We have a small but very mighty team here locally, marketing team and community outreach team that just does an outstanding job, you know, engaging in relationships with, you know, some of the local areas. We've got relationships with the soccer teams, both here in Vegas and in Reno as well, that gets the word out about Silver Summit and, you know, promotes activities and healthy behaviors. And, you know, as we, you know, look to educate people on the benefits of what we offer as coverage.
Talk to us some of the details about some of the programs. No One Eats Alone. Tell us a little bit more about those and what does that do and how does everybody benefit from that?
So, and some of this comes from our history, our legacy of, oftentimes states were moving their moms and kids who were covered in Medicaid into a managed care setting. And so back early on in the Centene days, and, you know, Silver Summit benefits from this history and this expertise, we wanted to make sure that we were offering programs for kids. And so we have some anti-bullying campaigns and anti-bullying books that we have distributed in many of our markets. And, you know, we felt that this was a very important program. No One Eats Alone Day at schools that we've been sponsoring here in Southern Nevada.
You have other programs. I'm just looking down at some of these strong youth, strong communities.
Yeah.
Working with the Football Hall of Fame. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, we've done that. You know, and that was another program that we rolled out a couple years ago in several different Centene markets. And where, you know, it's the kids love it because it's a lot of these NFL Hall of Famers that are joining you at these events and that are talking to the kids. And, you know, everybody eats that up.
I think Vegas is going to become a hot spot for you with our growth of sports, with the Vegas Golden Knights and making the Stanley Cup playoffs two years in a row. We got the Raiders moving in. Everybody keeps talking about a professional basketball team on their way. So we've got a lot of good stuff.
Vegas has a ton going on. It's a great community. It's, you know, it's a lot more than what people may see on TV in terms of, you know, the tourist destinations. It's a wonderful community, a lot of people that we work with that are looking to make a difference in the community. The Golden Knights have been an outstanding partner for us. We hope that we've been a good partner for them as well, doing these various events at schools and so forth. There's so much growth going on with the Raiders coming, you know, with the baseball team here as well, the minor league team. There's a lot to do, and it's pretty
awesome. It's exciting.
Awesome. Yeah.
So, Jeff, we've covered a lot of ground today. I think we probably gave our audience a real good bird's eye view about Silver Summit, everything that you're doing in the community. Is there anything that we didn't touch on that you want our audience to be aware of?
You know, I don't think there's anything different that I would add, just maybe reiterate or emphasize that, we're coming on 2 years. We've learned a lot, made a lot of progress. We've got a lot of work to do left, but we are very strongly committed to this market. And we believe that, you know, we deliver a unique experience for our members. And so we just hope to promote that, continue to promote that, get folks aware of that, and continue to grow our business.
Very good. Jeff Grahling, thank you for being on the show with us today. For those of you that want to catch an episode of Inside Medicine, you're able to do so online. And we look forward to seeing you here next Thursday and every Thursday, right at 10 o'clock in the studio here. Thanks, and you all make it a great day.